Hello, farmers. Welcome to another episode of bestfarmingtips.com. Today we are talking about fresh farm produce recipe. Best ever method to cook rabbit meat that is soft, juicy, and smell free. If you ask people how rabbit meat tastes like, you will possibly get three following answers. Number one, it tastes like chicken. This means it was cooked using one of the most common chicken recipes. Number two, it tastes like game meat. This means that it was probably dried first or grilled on charcoal or fire, the same way game meat is cooked. Number three, it tastes like rabbit. This probably implies that you got it right and used a good rabbit recipe. Rabbit meat should taste like a rabbit, not like something it is not and will never be. I have tried countless rabbit meat recipes, and I have reached a conclusion regarding the best method to follow when it comes to cooking rabbit, and we'll go through the whole process together today, from lighting charcoal to extinguishing it after the whole cooking process. While there are so many rabbit cooking recipes, only one method has proved to be a cut above the rest. It's the grilling on charcoal method. If you have an oven, you can still use an oven, then follow the steps I'm going to share with you shortly. I'm getting so hungry, I can't wait to eat rabbit meat once more. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do after butchering a rabbit is to wash it and try to get rid of as much blood as possible. After that, put the rabbit in a small dish where the meat will all fit. Sprinkle the whole rabbit with salt, then cover with tap water. Place the dish in a fridge for 24 hours. We don't want the meat to freeze, so don't put the dish in the freezer. We just want it to get a little cold, but not to freeze. The salted water will drain as much blood from the rabbit meat as possible, almost all of it in fact, and it will soften the meat. When eating rabbit meat, you certainly don't want to do as if you are practicing to fight a heavyweight champion like Mike Tyson. The salted water will also help season the inner parts of the rabbit meat with a little bit of salt, those parts that would never have accessed salt when seasoning the usual way. 24 hours later, your water will be red to maroon in color. It's because of the blood that has been drained from the meat. So rinse the meat once more. Then either cook it as a whole or first cut it into two if you are going to cook for one or two people only. You will cook the other half another day. Here are the things that you are going to need. 1. Charcoal and a braai stand or a barbecue grill or simply an oven. 2. A knife or a pair of kitchen scissors for cutting meat. 3. A kitchen brush for rubbing cooking oil. 4. A pair of tongs for flipping the meat. For the ingredients themselves, you are going to need the following. 1. Rabbit meat itself, either a whole rabbit or a half rabbit. If you are cooking for two people only, then you probably need just a half rabbit. 2. Cooking oil. 3. Salt. 4. Your favorite spice for roasting meat or braai or barbecuing meat. Now let's light the charcoal. At times, charcoal can be very difficult to light. I used to spend lots of minutes, if not close to an hour, trying to light charcoal, but now I do it with minimal struggle. All I simply do is to turn on the gas stove, place 3 or 4 pieces of charcoal on each valve, and wait for less than 5 minutes, and that's it. Your charcoal is ready to get things started. Arrange the charcoal on the braai stand or charcoal grill in such a way that the glowing sides of the charcoal face each other to increase heat. This will allow you to add and light more charcoal, this time using the already glowing charcoal. Simply blow some air several times on the charcoal or use any light object with a flat surface, such as a plastic plate. Now that we have our charcoal red, let's start cooking. It will take us roughly 30 to 45 minutes to cook the meat, depending on how much charcoal you are going to use and how hot it is. Step 1. Place the meat on the grill, either facing upwards or downwards, it's all the same. Use a kitchen brush to rub the upper side of the rabbit meat with vegetable cooking oil. Step 2. Season with salt. Also season with your favorite spice for roasting meat or dry spice. My favorite is Nyama Spice, made by a South African company called Freddy Heshko. The spice is excellent for flame grilling fish or rabbit or chicken or even pork. It can be found in some parts of the Southern Africa, such as South Africa and Zimbabwe. You can also use Portuguese chicken spice or lemon and herb spice. They are both well for rabbit grilling. If you want your meat hot, then you can add your usual hot stuff. But personally, I don't like anything with hot chili. Step 3. Use a pair of tongs to flip the meat, then use a kitchen brush to rub the remaining side of the rabbit meat with cooking oil. Step 4. Simply repeat step 2. Step 5. We want the whole meat to cook over a period of 30 to 45 minutes, so keep flipping the sides frequently, probably after every 4 to 5 minutes. As you flip the sides using your pair of tongs, you may rub portions of the meat you feel need more cooking oil, and afterwards, sprinkle more salt or more spice on the rubbed portions as need arises. We don't want our meat to be dry and hard to chew. We want it as juicy and soft as possible, and cooking oil will help us achieve that. Step 6. After about 30 minutes of cooking the meat, it should be over 90% complete. Use a knife or a pair of chicken scissors or shears to cut the meat through the vertebral column or simply the backbone into two parts. Cutting the meat through the vertebral column helps you ascertain if the central part of the meat has cooked well. If it has, then your meat is ready. If it hasn't, then bring that central part to heat and let it cook for 5 or so minutes. Now that your rabbit meat is ready, you will agree with me that this is the tastiest rabbit recipe you have ever tried. You can serve your meat just like that, or you can first cut the big pieces of meat further into smaller chunks, whichever way suits your preferences. Personally, I serve as is without further cutting the meat. Don't forget to get a metal dish, fill it with water, then use metal cooking tongs to grab all glowing pieces of charcoal and throw them into the dish to extinguish them. Leave them there for 10 minutes, then remove them from the water so that they can dry. You will use this charcoal again next time you want to grill with charcoal. It's easier to light used charcoal as compared to fresh one. In our next video, I'll teach you how I make simple rabbit bacon without any special machine or apparatus. All you need is rabbit meat and a knife. So make sure you subscribe to my channel, Best Farming Tips, so that you get notified when I upload a new video, together with many other exciting videos that I upload every week. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos. Goodbye.